And he said to them, "Go into all the world and proclaim the good news to the whole creation." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Gather today in the beauty of God's creation here at the Botanic Garden Center in Fort Worth as we celebrate our calling to serve God in and through this beautiful tradition, the Episcopal Church. Today's appointed passages from Scripture pick up themes appropriate to our setting today, themes of creation. The passage from Ezekiel says, "Everything will live where the river goes." And from Romans, Paul writes that creation waits in hope that the creation itself will be set free from the bondage to decay, that creation groans in labor pains. And in Mark's gospel, Jesus says to the 11, "Go into all the world and proclaim the good news to the whole creation." And so we gather in this place, which was once the site of three natural springs, that's true, but also a cotton gin and a gravel pit and a dumping ground for the U.S. Cavalry. Certainly this garden is evidence that everything can live where the river goes, and creation quite literally can be set free from the bondage to decay. So in the midst of the beauty of God's creation, in the midst of the garden, and indeed a garden restored to new life, we gather to remember and declare God's presence in creation, God's action in creation, and the power of God's love to renew and resurrect creation, to restore and reconcile creation to communion with God. The altar around which we are gathered today and the Paschal candle which stands in our midst come to us from our newest diocesan community of faith, the Episcopal Church of Wise County. Episcopalians in Wise County have been displaced for several years. A little over a year ago, Ellen and Mark Whitley contacted Bishop High about the possibility of planting a church. And so he met with them for a cup of coffee on his way to Wichita Falls one day. Bishop High started dreaming with the Whitleys, along with Jill and Phil McClendon and Sarah and Clyde Walker. And the group grew to a dozen or so. And it came to pass that one day they went to explore a location, a wedding chapel in town, once upon a time an Episcopal church. They did not have access to enter the building that day, but they looked in the windows, and then they said noonday prayer outside on the very grounds that had been consecrated by Bishop Garrett as the Episcopal mission of the Ascension. And on the feast day of the Ascension, they moved into this historic building. And from around the diocese and beyond, they received vessels, chalices and patens and candles and prayer books and so forth. And Mark Whitley, a woodworker and carpenter, built a new missal stand, which is here, and this lectern and a credence table and this stand for the Paschal candle and this altar, honoring God in a traditional way, using no nails, no screws, no hardware. Mark built this altar by hand using only wood. After years of wandering in the desert, perhaps wondering if God can set a table in the wilderness, the Episcopal community of faith in Wise County now gathers around this altar with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, participating in the foretaste of the heavenly banquet. Today, all the diocese gathers in the garden around this altar. Garden and heavenly banquet, beginning and end, Alpha and Omega. In the Eastern Church, the Russian Orthodox Church specifically, it is claimed that there is only one Eucharist. One Eucharist forever repeated, indivisible. It is constantly divided and shared, extending through time, one perpetual flow from the Last Supper to the heavenly banquet. That is a beautiful image. One Eucharist extending through time, one perpetual flow, connecting the body of Christ, uniting all times and all places, all eternity, past, present, and future, gathered and connected in holy communion with God and one another. For this celebration is not simply a foretaste of the heavenly banquet, however true. It is God's vision for creation, communion with God and one another. We are participating in God's vision, God's dream. And week after week, we come to the altar and stretch out our arms and we hear the words, the body of Christ. And as the early church theologians claimed, we become what we receive. We become who we are, living members of the risen body of Christ, living members of the body, los brazos de Dios, the arms of God. I acknowledge this suggests a high church theology. Baptized people are called to a purpose beyond ourselves. We proclaim and embody God's love. This calls to my mind the familiar prayer from the daily office of prayer for mission and morning prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hardwood of the cross, that everyone might come within reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your spirit, that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you for the honor of your name. So clothe us in God's spirit, that we may be los brazos de Dios, as we not only proclaim but embody love without conditions, unmerited grace, undeserved forgiveness, love. As our new presiding bishop says, if it's not about love, it's not about God. Now, the proclamation of God's love always takes place in a particular context. And if we are honest, our particular context has some unique challenges. We as a diocese, not unlike the community of faith in Wise County, know something about time in the desert or the wilderness. If we remember the Exodus story, the people of Israel are led through the wilderness, through the darkness, into the promised land by a pillar of fire. The pillar of fire is seen as the visible, reassuring presence of God. The pillar of fire dispels the darkness. Well, every year, at the celebration of the great vigil of Easter, we light that fire. The newly lighted paschal candle processes down the center aisle into the dark nave, and three times along the way, the deacon sings the light of Christ, and three times the gathered congregation responds, thanks be to God. By the light of the paschal candle, the poetic hymn of light, the exalted, is sung. And by that same light, the Bible is read. The stories of our salvation history are told. And by that light, prayers are offered and sacraments are celebrated. And the light from the paschal candle shines throughout the season of Easter for all celebrations and liturgies. It will shine at the celebrations of baptism throughout the year. It will shine prominently every time we gather to celebrate life at a loved one's burial. The paschal candle stands over the remains of the body and proclaims Easter proclaims the light of Christ, proclaims resurrection, proclaims Christ is risen. The pillar of fire, the visible, reassuring presence of God, shines in the darkness and declares love. Every year during Holy Week, we hear the story, we live into the story of disciples who betray and deny and abandon Jesus out of fear and self-preservation. The angel says, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised." And as the story goes, by the power of the Holy Spirit, by the power of God's love, this body of lost and fearful followers is raised to new life, risen. It's a new body, a risen body, called by baptism to proclaim and embody God's love. In the name of the Holy Trinity, one God in whom we live and move and have our being.
Amen.